Francis.
Hey, what's up? Scott Baston from St. Francis. What's going on, man?
Doing good, man. I just got your message, figured I would give you a ring and see how the broadcast is going.
Well, I'm, I'm tweaking some things out, man. You know, it's like I'm, you know, it's trial and error. I'm playing around a little bit. What's going on with you, man?
Nothing much. Sitting around, getting ready to curl up in front of the TV with my wife and watch American Horror Story, which is one of our favorite weekly traditions, you know, in our TV tradition. So,
cool. So, what you got going on with yourself?
Nothing too exciting. Just everything. got tons of stuff coming up. Tomorrow night, I just got asked just a minute ago to go and sit in at the Georgia Theater with some pals of mine from Perpetual Groove, and we're going to be at the Georgia Theater tomorrow night. I'm going to go sing with those guys. It'll be in honor of our relationship that we started over 10 years ago. We made a record together. It's been a long time. It seems like a long time, but it's, you know, 10 years really isn't all that much. It just has gone by so quick, you know. But, you know, I'm going to be over there with them tomorrow night, and then I'm getting ready to go play the Big House down in Macon on Saturday with St. Francis. We're doing Fly South down in at the Big House, the Allman Brothers Museum.
Oh, wow. That's cool, man.
Yeah, we're stoked about that. That's going to be a really good show. It's a good opportunity for us to go down and kind of pay homage to some of our influence. And also, that's where I kind of like got my start, was down in Macon, Georgia. And when I was on the road with Moonshine still, you know, we toured. That was our home base for a while, was Macon and Milledgeville. So,
right.
So that's kind of where we were.
New York Nick here. I'm live from the production studio, and I got Scott Baston on the line. Now, are you still with CIA Records?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I am. We are working right now on getting our new office space up and running. We were downtown in Athens at the Fred Building for a little bit, and then we moved out of the Fred Building because we didn't have enough space to kind of grow into that space, and plus they were getting ready to do some modifications to the building, so we moved out of there. And a lot of our production team is out in between Placerville, LA, Huntington Beach, you know, on the West Coast, and we are the hub kind of in the East Coast between Nashville and Athens and New York, and you know, so we get all the fun out on the East Coast, and you know, they get all the earthquakes out on the West Coast, so, you know. But, you know, we are doing really well. We've got some great artists that we've signed, and St. Francis is definitely doing well. We're moving into finishing up the final mixes of our record with producer Tommy Cooper and Joe Denon, which they're out of Nashville, Tennessee.
Right.
Working out of Omnisound and with AFAB Studios, and, you know, just a great bunch of guys, and you know, it's great working for the label that you helped to found, and you know, because that's kind of the way to go these days. You know, so majors don't really exist like they used to. You know, you don't, the big deals and getting discovered are far enough in between. You know, so you kind of have to make your way. I think Zach Brown has proven the stability of that, and the smart play that they made, you know, by doing stuff like that.
What genres are you focusing on?
We are basically taking on a very ambitious label. So we kind of like pursue just about every genre of music, you know, we're pursuing. And a lot of these artists are crossover artists anyway. So they wear different hats, you know, so they'll come in and they may be classically trained, you know, and they may go play rock and roll, and then they may turn around and do a jazz gig. But for the most part, whatever their passion is, their main passion is what we want to focus on. We have, besides our band who helped to create the label and sign on with the label, we were one of the first artists. There's a band called Greco.
Right.
They used to be Liars and Lovers here out of Athens, Georgia. And we've got a band called Josh Robertson and the Hinges, which is out of Columbia, South Carolina, and those guys are amazing, and they've been working some with Band of Horses and you know, just doing some great stuff. And their stuff is more like kind of the Crazy Horse type stuff, like Neil Young and the Crazy Horse type stuff. And you know, we've got a guy that actually does like lounge music. His name is Laurent is what his name is, and he's more of Michael Bublé kind of guy. And you know, Juvie and the Morning After, which is another group from Macon, they are more hip rock is what they're calling themselves, which is they just did a stint where they went out and did the Jimmy Kimmel Show live.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was an amazing. And if you get a chance, look them up. Look up Juvie and the Morning After and check out their band. They're absolutely incredible. And they actually just relocated to Athens as well, and they seem to be doing very well. They're kind of like leading that kind of move as far as music goes over here in Athens.
Now, do you have a website where, you know, folks can go to and...
As of right now, we are officially, because we are a startup label, we are officially getting ready to launch the entire thing. We're going to do it early spring of 2013. We are amassing, the thing for us is that the artists have been at it forever. A lot of these artists have been doing this forever, and they just haven't had the right kind of backing and push for what they needed to do, you know. And a lot of times, you know, as you know, a lot of artists get overlooked because they, you know, Nashville or the majors are looking for one specific kind of artist, and they want to sell that all the way to the bank, you know, and they'll make 50 of those kinds of artists, you know. So for us, what we wanted to do was get all of our ducks in a row and then make an official drop, like all at once, where when we did our drop, everything would be in motion already, and you would be able to see like all of our artists and link with the website and see the business and see who we're connected with. And we are connected with some pretty major players out there, which is good for us, but it's also good for the artist.
So if I was an artist and, you know, I was wanting to record, you know, mix and master and get my name out there, what benefit would I have coming to see Scott Baston at CIA Records?
Well, I'm not gonna give you a line of crap, I tell you that.
Well, I mean, come on now, everybody's gotta start somewhere. And if I wanted to come and work with you, I mean, what benefit would I have?
I would basically suggest that you, you know, for now, we have 12 artists that we've got on the burner right now. We've got six that have signed, and we're working with. Come 2013, we're going to be expanding out after we do the major drop. So, I mean, you could always look me up on Facebook and find me there, or you could find me, you know, just kind of find me through either other bands, you know, like Josh Roberts and the Hinges or Juvie and the Morning After, Across the Wide, Shane Bridges Band. Let's see, there's Mark Van Allen, who plays with me, who's played with everybody and their mother, you know, he's out there in
right.
reach. But until we do the official drop, we're kind of artists.
I'm still here. That. Somebody's trying to call in. So, you know, it sounds real exciting that you're getting ready to crank it up, man. It sounds awesome.
Well, I can't wait. It's a very artist-friendly label, which is great. The artists really, I mean, we're all artists, and we have a lot of technology that's tied to the label too that helps us to be able to kind of not have to scratch and scrape with a lot of these venues and a lot of the kind of rigmarole of regular, you know, the regular life of being a musician out on the road. So, you know, I look forward to dropping this thing, and I would encourage everybody to keep your ears open for it. There is another CIA Records out there that actually goes by CIA Records, but we are Chromatone Music is what we're called.
Chromatone Music.
Yeah, and it's Chromatone Intermedia Associates, which is actually, we just reduced it down to CIA Records, you know. But, you know, I think you'll be hearing a lot from us, and you'll be seeing a lot.
Well, I really appreciate you giving me a call and filling me in on what you got going, and... you know, continued success and success. You know, I mean, it's not an easy gig. Before you go, though, rock and roll in this town. They say it's dead. What do you say?
Now, where are you broadcasting from, as a matter of fact?
I'm broadcasting from Gwinnett County.
Oh, I love me some Atlanta, man. We just got done doing the Star Bar in Atlanta last weekend for the opening of a CD release party that a friend of mine asked us to come finish out the night for, which was the Lindsey Rakers Band.
Right.
Let me tell you, man, every time I come to Atlanta, I am so impressed by the diversity of musicians and the people that come out, the real music listeners that come out and pay attention.
Now, where are you based from?
We are out of Athens, Georgia. We are over here in Athens, so we see a lot of the music downtown, but I'll be honest with you, man, I spend a lot of time in Atlanta kind of trolling around the jazz bars because I have two of my musicians live in Atlanta, which is Carlos Enamorado. He's up at the jazz program at Georgia State. And another one that's about to move up there. He's actually a real bishop in a church. He plays keys for me, which is Brandon McCray.
Right. So is your studio in Athens also?
Say again?
Is your studio in Athens?
We actually have studios all over the country. We use studios out of New York. We've got one in Placerville. We definitely work with John Keane. We work up in Portland, Oregon. Of course, L.A., you know. And we kind of spread it out. These are all of our pals and our friends who have been in the music business as well. And they can't make money recording from a lot of these majors anymore. It's a very elite group of people that have all kind of clicked together to kind of like keep each other afloat. And I feel like that's the worst part about the business right now, is the fact that there are a bunch of those little bitty cliques. It's your mama's mama's daddy,
right,
grandma. You know, I think that that kind of, in order to get to the really good stuff, you kind of got to sort through the BS sometimes and find the jewels.
Now, I'm assuming you heard of the young rock and roll inspiring band, to be a rock band, the Athens Band.
Oh yeah, man, I sure have. You know, I saw them do the Fall Festival down in Watkinsville last year, and then I've seen them again. The guy that I guess the lead singer comes into the place where my wife works down here in Athens, and every now and then I'll see him come through. So,
you think it's easier starting from ground zero, being a young band, than it is being a bunch of old guys trying to get a record deal? Or, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, it's like a football player. They start when they're 8 years old. They progress. They go to college. Then, you know, before they know it, is it kind of like sports, you know, being in a band and trying to get it going?
I'm sorry, you cut out there. I didn't mean to interrupt. I don't really look at it that way anymore, because I used to think so, and I used to drive myself in the ground thinking that if I didn't make it by the time I was 30 years old, then I was just a washout.
Right.
But I think with bands out there like Blackberry Smoke, I think with band and the great bands too, I might add, you know, you've got bands like Blackberry Smoke, you've got bands like, you know, the Zac Brown Band.
Right.
You've got, you know, older musicians tend to make more memorable musicians.
Right.
You know, I'm not looking for the flash in the pan, all the little bitty emo bands that are in today, gone tomorrow. You know, I want something that's gonna like stick with me. I want it to stick to my ribs and really, really move me in a way that I'm gonna want to listen to it for the rest of my life. You know,
what is a rock band have to do to gain fans? I mean, do they cut the CD and give a CD out to everybody, or do you feel like they need to like beat the bushes and go here and play here and play there? A lot of these bands in Atlanta feel like, you know, they oversaturate themselves.
Well, you know, I do believe that there is an element to the touring that is good. You have to get out there and you have to make sure that, especially in this climate, you know, it's hard to go tour like it used to be. You know, it used to be gas was cheap as hell and you could be out on the road and it didn't matter. You know, you could make your money and you could live from town to town. But unfortunately, it's not that way anymore. You know, you really have to focus on honing in on your fans, like through social media.
Right.
Find your niche.
right.
and go there.
Right.
You know, be smart about it. Don't just hit the road and go to every little, you know, whiskey-soaked joint in the world, you know. Really find out where that niche market is for you and go attack it. And if you get in those markets, get to know some of the musicians there that are looking to do the same thing that you're doing and become their friends, man, and make it genuine. You know?
Some of the famous rock bands, you know, like, you know, when they interview, you know, guys like Chris Cornell and stuff, they say, you know, you have to be a local hero before you take it to the road.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, do you feel that is key, that you become a local hero, you gain, you know, 250, 300, 400 fans in your general area, and then you fork it off and you go down to Florida and you go to South Carolina and then you go to North Carolina and then you go to Alabama and you go out west? I mean, is that the way it's supposed to be done?
Well, actually, I don't think so, man. I think that's part of it. That can be, but I have to say that as far as being a local hero, I think there's many ways that you can be a local hero.
Right.
You know, I think that more people, you know, you can always amass a crowd of drinkers and drug users if you want that kind of crowd. You know,
right.
they're always there and around to help build you up. But, you know, what do you do for your community? You know, how do you reach out to the people that wouldn't normally hear you had you not done that?
Right.
You know,
right.
That's really what makes a local hero in my mind.
Well, a lot of the bands that I do talk to and, you know, kind of get some input, you know, they feel like they do better out of state than they do in town here.
Oh, and it's true. A lot of people take for granted, their bands in their town because they know they can go see them whenever.
Right.
And, you know, that is one thing that, you know, I always tell people is, look, if you feel like you're oversaturating the market, and you're seeing and you really feel like you're not being appreciated there, step back a little bit, you know. Step back from that market, do some writing, start really researching some of these places that, you know, if you were having good attendance in the beginning, start searching some of these places that are similar to where your market is.
Right.
And go give it a shot, you know. Once you have that rotation, and it has to make sense. You can't go out there and live off of peanut butter and jelly for 6-7 weeks at a time. You know, it's just
absolutely. No, I totally agree. Scott, I appreciate you calling in, and really, continued success, and I hope everything works out for you. Scott Baston with CIA Records, and what is it,
Chromatone Intermedia Associates.
Check them out, man. Get online. They're going to be cranking it up in Athens here shortly. Scott Baston, thank you, man.
Hey, thank you so much, Nick.
I appreciate it. Thanks for calling. All right. You want to give me a call, 770-963-1478. We're going to listen to some treat, 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 trip.